Hello, I am a domain support engineer in the systems management space here at Dell. Today we will be covering the OpenManage Enterprise integration for VMware vCenter plugin, commonly referred to as OMEVV. Firmware deployment prerequisites. In order to deploy a firmware baseline via the OMEVV plugin, you will need the Update Manager plugin installed in OpenManage Enterprise. We have already installed the needed plugins and registered with vCenter for this demonstration. These hosts must also have the OME Advanced Plus license installed for this option to be successful, which takes place of the traditional license needed for OMIVV. Firmware repository profile: the server has to be added to OME via the DRAC and added to a cluster in vCenter for OMEVV to identify that in the inventory. Repository profile then uses a firmware catalog to get the firmware information. In this case, OME is integrated with OMEVV and connects to downloads.dell.com automatically. The baseline profile uses a repository profile as a baseline to compare the firmware inventory with the current device inventory. For this example, we will create a repo for ESX server from the Dell customized images. And here is the site that we plan to use. We'll select plugins, update manager, and repository. Create repository. We will call this the ESX test. Now for the base catalog, we will select index catalog. For catalog groups, we will select the ESXi catalog for enterprise servers. We see the most current data is September 5th of 2023, but we could use an older file if desired. And we can change this to automatic or manual. Select next. And I have one host in OME already added. We'll select next and finish. Okay, then once the repository is created, we'll slide over to vCenter, go to an OpenManage Enterprise plugin, compliance, and deployment. On the repository profile, we want to resync the Update Manager plugin repo profiles. So go ahead and do that now. Okay, so now we see the share path and the location, the name of the catalog.xml file, and that it came from Update Manager plugin. All right, so now we need to create a baseline compliance. Before we can do that, we need a baseline profile. So we go to baseline profiles and click create baseline profile. We'll get started. We'll name this ESX test. Select next. We're going to select the firmware repository profile that we just created. ESX test and next. Now we have to associate the cluster that that host is in. So we browse and then mine is in Kingdom. So my host is that one. And next. Every Sunday, the Drift report runs and verifies whether or not the firmware is within compliance. Next and finish. Okay, so now that that's completed, we can go to baseline compliance and we can see Kingdom is there where my host resides, and we want to run the firmware wizard. Select get started. It's ESX test our baseline profile and select next. And we don't see any updates. So let's select allow firmware downgrade. So we're seeing that 6.10.80 is available in the catalog and that IDRAC is currently sitting on 7.0.0. We'll go ahead and select that and say next. We'll call this job del test. And next. Del test, update now, and finish. Okay, so we can go over here to the logs. See that the job was requested for update for the IDRAC. We can also access the IDRAC maintenance and lifecycle log. And we can see that it's currently downloading the IDRAC. So the update is underway. This entire process is repeated for vSAN or custom repositories. Custom repos, we point to the network path such as a share location, including the catalog.xml in the path name. And then, as mentioned, it's a repeat of the previous steps performed to have a cluster associated to a compliance baseline. That completes this video, and have a great day.